I'm Corbett Wall with DV Auction, here with a 3-minute cattle market update for Friday, July the 29th, where that basis is gone. We've been talking about it the last several times we've visited here about how the basis is bound to flip-flop, and we've been running for so long, for the last 2 or 3 months, with a huge basis, $6, $7, as much as $10. And for the few of you that don't really understand that, the basis is simply the difference between the cash market and the spot futures market. And when you own cattle, you're long the cash market, so you need to be short or at least buying a put or something to hedge yourself in the futures market. And when you do that, you're really betting on the market to go down. And when the futures market does not line up with cash and it's below that, well, then that's a little bit of extra money you get to take advantage of. And a lot of times, that's the only money that there is really to make in the cattle feeding business is the basis. So that basis is pretty much gone now. We've seen a big rise in the live cattle futures this week, especially on Monday there being up the limit. And now it's looking like fats are gonna be at least steady, but the heck of it is they've got so much captive supply, it's gonna be hard to gain dollars and dollars in the cash market. So if the futures market is higher or gains more this week than what the cash market does, it's really going to tighten that thing up. But you know, as of on Wednesday's close there, the basis was really just about a dollar or something compared to what the weighted average was last week. But your live cattle futures, looking at the October contract where most of your play is now, on Wednesday it was still up 47 cents. Thursday back down 95, couldn't hold it, but end of the day Thursday at 112.10, and your August spot market is higher than that, so it's closer to what your cash is. Feeder cattle on the August contract is where everybody's still playing. Wednesday was down 17 where everything else was up, but down not much. Thursday down $1.80. To end the day on Thursday at 140.47. Your CME feeder cattle index is at 140.105, so pretty close. Real-time index on Cattle Market Central is more than that. It's at 143.57, but it reflects Thursday's sales, which were quite a bit higher, and the CME index will not show that for a whole nother day. So it gained over $1.15 on Thursday's sales, so that's why it's running quite a bit premium to what CME cash feeder index is, because it's more current. No fat cattle trade at all this week. Usually we have a few deals. We've had less than 1,000 head trade negotiated so far this week out of the five area, which is nothing. And those few sales are around $1.85 dressed, which was some better than last week. And it should be some better, but like I said, it's going to be hard for them to gain dollars and dollars this week, even though the board's been up pretty good. Your slaughter this week is good, maybe not quite as good as last week, maybe not quite as good as everybody hoped, but still running big, 447,000 through Thursday, which is just 2,000 less than last week's impressive kill, but 20,000 more than the same week a year ago. They say we're current, but if you look at the last actual slaughter that come in for the week ending July the 16th, your steer carcass weights were back up to 880 pounds. You look at your cash feeder cattle market, El Reno, Oklahoma had 7,500 head on Wednesday. Feeders were called $1 to $5 higher. Most all your Wednesday markets were quite a bit higher, not a lot of tests and calves because they're usually enjoying being out with their mothers or just not much reason to sell calves right now until they need to get those calves weaned or pull them off running out of grass. But even though it's been awful hot, we have had some sporadic rains around and good timely rains, so no place is really hurting that bad, even though it's been over 100 degrees in a lot of places around the country. Look at Cattle Market Central, some individual quotes. My good friend Mike Frieden sold his big green yearlings on Wednesday at St. Joe Stockyards at 89 head of good black steers, weighed 877 pounds at 142. That was around 10:30 in the morning. Impressive sale. I was glad to see him do that. Good guy there. Actually works at the stockyards. He's the only skinner I know that gets paid to watch his traps go off. But I hate to tell him, but you look at another market at the same day in Bassett, Nebraska. It's just hard to run with. Get up there in the sand hills and you got those farmer feeders, and they're just hard to stay with Bassett, Nebraska. You look at just after that, 2:15 in the afternoon on Wednesday, they had 111 steers weighed 965, also bring 142. That's 3 minutes, and we'll talk to you next week.